Don't name names, Ken, but of 12, how many do you reckon?
Five or six, I would have thought.
All right. Well, they're the world champions.
Now you know what it sounds like.
Coming up for the Boomers later on this year. Time to get Perth. They've been in this situation where they've lost two grand final series deciding games in Perth. So there is some chance for Wollongong.
Great start, BT, for the Perth Wildcats. Good aggressive play from Damien Martin.
A lot of pressure from Martin on Damien Martin on Reece Martin, the ball carrier. There's the ball to Campbell. Shenta didn't come at him. Gives it out to Davidson. He likes the free, but that falls way, way short. Way backs into Campbell. There's Lisch wanting to get Shenta involved. A little pass over the top. Shenta with the baseline one-handed jumper.
Hammer, you were talking about a go-to guy for the Perth Wildcats. Sean Reddish, he was 3 of 5 in the first half, but he's one you look at and say that I'd get him a few more touches.
Davidson knocked away by Shenta, no foul. Remember, he's on 3 at the moment. Someone in the crowd's got a whistle as well. Way into Shenta. He wanted it. He called for it. Now, don't lose your positioning inside the paint. He tries to muscle his way in. Davidson, good D. Couldn't get the drag over the top in the end.
You can't miss it from that close.
Can't, can you? Reece Martin makes him pay at the other end.
And that's the penalty at the other end when you miss a shot like that. Wollongong are going to run it on you. And that's how they got their percentages up at 60% in the first half.
They're down by a point, Perth. Andrew, when does the scoreboard pressure start to tell on you in a grand final as Damien Martin nuts at 3?
Well, right now, it really told on the Perth Wildcats early on, but right now, when there's never more than a basket in it the last 7 or 8 minutes.
Well, Perth must start at some stage to think, gee, what
do we have to do?
Yeah.
What do we have to do to shake them off? And that's what I'm saying. As long as the Wollongong Hawks can hang in there, go down to the wire and give themselves a chance.
I don't think they do. I think the Perth Wildcats know exactly what they have to do. They have to get stops, and then that flows into their transition game. And when they're taking the ball out of the net like they have 40% of the time, because Wollongong are shooting 60%, they can't get any flow going.
Just 7 on the shot clock here for Wollongong. Campbell, baseline jumper. That was really, really sweet. Lisch had a hand there.
And that's one of those ones you look at and say, well, there's not a whole lot more the defense can do. Running out, it's just a great play by Matty Campbell. The Perth Wildcats, you know, they'll live with that to a certain extent.
Stevie Wade looking to use his athleticism against Saville. Got inside, did it really well in the end. Had to follow there just in case as well.
Back to Reddish, Drewy. I think they certainly need to establish him, and certainly in transition as well. There was a time before he was running the lanes. They need to be able to give it to him when he gets open.
Tregar was disappointed he didn't get the ball inside then. Beautiful pass from Martin to Gruber.
Just great execution again. They have been the premier team in the half-court sets of running their offense and finding the open man.
Reddish puts it on the floor, attacks the rim, draws the foul from Tregar.
And that's what we're talking about with Sean Reddish. This time, he does it himself. See, from the top of the ring, just a simple one-on-one play. And just a little push, they ping Tregar on.
You'd love to see Reddish get the ball on the elbow in an isolation play with screens happening on the weak side and give him a chance to use his athleticism, because he's a size of a 4-man, but he's got the athleticism of a 3-man. Mm. So he's a very difficult player to be able to match up in a one-on-one contest.
Kem Trukar, just got to tread a little carefully because he's on the 3. If he collected another foul in the next minute or two, he would be out until the last quarter probably.
And there's another reason why you go to Reddish if Trukar's going to try and stay with Reddish.
Great D, Sav.
There is Reddish. Gets it in the corner to Martin. Martin with a penetrating drive, the dish out. The ball handling not all that clean. Here's Reddish in the post. Luke Martin tried to put a hand there. Back out to Lisch. A long range 3. Brings the crowd to their feet.
And this is the time the Wollongong Hawks now have to go at something. They're out by 4 points, and it's danger times again to keep this crowd out of it.
It is. Don't reckon they can afford to get 8-10 points behind here. Saville takes it to the rim, aggressively scores, and will shoot. for the three-point play.
Glenn Saville really picked it up. 13 points now, 5 of 7. It's 71% from the field. He's also got the three rebounds. And what an aggressive play to the basket. Much needed time.
Who's your Larry Senstock medalist for the best player in the grand final series if you had to pick one right now?
Right now, I quite... Well, it's over the whole three games. And right now, Kevin Lisch has put up his hand. He'd be one that you're looking at to say would be in contention for the Perth Wildcats.
I think it depends on who wins, BT.
That's true.
If Perth win, I think it's Lisch. I think if Wollongong win, you have to go for a guard.
Right. Saville, crowd doing their best to force the miss, and they do. That's a win for the crowd. They like their work, but the offensive board's good for Wollongong. Here's Saville again, puts it on the floor, breezes past Catalini, and Gruber sticks it in for two.
All of a sudden, it's tied up again. They just find a way to be able to stay in games, and that's what you have to do on the opposition's floor to be able to be in the game at the end, to be able to give yourself a chance.
Redditch missed there. Gordy McCloud almost put a block on Kev Lisch then. On the court, here's Luke Martin. Bit of help there from Gruber. Knocked away, and it'll be a Wollongong ball, and a substitution here for both teams. Galen Young and Wagstaff step in. Conrad takes the spot of Saville. So Saville back, really having an effect on this game. Gordy McCloud says to him, well done.
Shenson Redditch out for the Perth Wildcats.
Ball inside, quick move of the ball, Gruber to Luke Martin. He wants the block. Conrad. No one willing to shoot it as though Conrad puts up a breathtaking shot in the end that was never going to go.
That was from your territory, Drewy.
That was a deep, deep shot.
There's Wagstaff just on the court, nails the three.
Always tough to do when you come in, only been in the game 10 seconds, a wide open opportunity presents itself. He's good
Davidson
enough to knock
and Young
it down.
Look at this, they're starting to wrap around. Davidson pushed him away. Young clapped him in the face and says, I sucked you right into that one. Oh boy, the two big boys in there banging.
You're a great lip reader, BT. Look at this.
Like, there's good defensive pressure extending it.
Wagstaff thought about the three again, the whack around the back from Martin. It'll be four fouls against the Hawks. Next one will put them in the bonus.
And that's what happens in play. When you talk about the pressure of playoff basketball, there's no... If this is round 13, Wollongong playing Perth, there's no way Galen Young's at the centre line putting on-ball pressure on Larry Davidson.
Beveridge and Radford, coach and assistant coach there.
Galen Young's done a good job, though, coming in late and being able to establish a role of a bit of an agitator, and it does all the dirty work, and normally the Americans aren't coming in doing that.
He has indeed been that. Look at him and Gruber go at it off the ball. You can see them down the bottom of the frame there. There's another attempt. Nowhere near, but the offensive rebound. Lisch puts it up, a high floating shot. It's really rough
and
very physical inside the paint.
Great.
Oh boy, wowee, as Conrad gets it to Davidson. Gruber goes to work on Young, takes him to the rack, sticks it, and will shoot the third.
Damn, run. What a play by Dave Gruber. Had to shake and bake. Have a look at the work down and the contact. He's just had to battle to buggery down the other end trying to contain Galen Young on the defensive end, and then he is good enough to get the play down on the offensive end.
This draws the scores level. Some pressure on the ball from Wollongong was a little late arriving. Catalini, the veteran, looking for his fourth championship. Here's Young and Davidson. They definitely don't like each other. The give to Lisch. Held the ball away from Gruber, drew the foul.
That was great, weak side cutting from the Perth Wildcats, and a very good, hard, solid foul from Gruber that wasn't going to give up an easy shot from Lisch.
Hammer, Dave Gruber is having an outstanding impact on this game. He's got 9 points, he's 4-4 from the field, and his physical presence down low. He's undersized in a lot of circumstances, but he has been fantastic tonight.
Saville and Tregar about to step back into the game.
Well, Gruber plays that similar role that Galen Young does, probably without the in-your-face sort of agitating...
Without the bravado.
That's a good word, Drew. I like it. Let's go with the bravado.
That's his fourth, I think, is it, Gruber? May well be. Check the stats for you. It is his fourth for Gruber. So he'll sit for a while. Can't afford to have him out, as the boys just mentioned. He's been a real spark in this grand final series for Wollongong. Saville, just fresh on the court. Lisch, dish to Robbins. Back to Lisch. Thought he had an opening for three there. Galen Young just applied a hip and shoulder on Davidson as he banged him inside the paint. Here's Young. Got Davidson off the deck. Young went with a pass when he probably shouldn't have. Catalini finds the open man in Lisch. Lisch a little bit short on the shot. Davidson and Wagstaff tangle. And Davidson with a push. That's called on Wagstaff.
That's a terrible call, Billy. Wagstaff got that ball clean. And the foul was on Davidson.
In fact, Davidson had almost given up. Just pushed him out of the way.
If anything, it's a no call. Just play on. That is not a good one.
Luke Martin. The turnover forced. A beautiful trap.
Karma.
Against Rhys Martin.
Jeez, they're letting him play.
They certainly are.
Contact on the ball handler.
Been brilliantly reffed, actually. They have let him play. Here's Lisch to the base. Sticks it in for two. Perth back out by three at the 3 minute to go mark in the third quarter.
This has been an adjustment year for Kevin Lisch. He played in a program at college where he wasn't a big-time scorer and they had to work the ball around for 40-odd seconds. Now he needs to be able to step up as a scorer. He's got to the line 10 times. That's not...
Have a look at Kevin Lisch. And he just takes it to the rack.
Surely that's Perth ball.
Well, we'd like to see the replay on that one. It was hard to tell from where we're sitting, but it looked that way, didn't it?
Well, at the moment, 3 points up the Wildcats. Their last championship in the 2000 year, so it's been almost 10 years. Let's go and have a listen to Rob Beveridge of the Perth Wildcats.
And you get out of your stance. Get down low in your stance. Make them back pedal here. We don't want them turning the corner on this. Okay? So it's the screen's over here. With this group, switch. Right? Switch the on ball. So when they come off this, it's contact. I don't want them diving. So when you come under, you've got to hold that man. You've got to come out to your stance. So right now, you guys can switch this out. Let's run. Four. Okay, four. So come out. Get that go-go. Turn the corner. You have to post up beside you. Hey, you're a Sicilian man. You guys lift out of the corner. So Gamo, you look to get in the paint.
Well, Beveridge there, they look a committed outfit. The Wildcats looking for their fifth championship. Crowd sensing just a little opening here for Perth.
Great to see some Wollongong Hawks fans make the journey all the way out west to be able to support their team.